Welcome to this how-to video from cBioPortal. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use cBioPortal to define groups of samples based on the expression level of a gene of interest, and then compare those groups to identify differences in outcomes or other clinical or molecular features. Note, this video does assume you're familiar with the basics of cBioPortal. If you're new, we have other resources for you available at the link shown here. With that, let's jump over to the cBioPortal website and get started. For this example, we're going to start in study view. Here, I'm selecting a TCGA pan-cancer atlas study in adult brain tumors. The scenario we want to address is, I have a gene of interest, and I want to explore differences between samples that have low expression of that gene versus high expression. When I say differences, that could be differences in a clinical feature, like overall survival, or patterns of mutations or other molecular features. We'll start by adding a chart to show the overall expression patterns of my gene of interest, which we can do here in the charts menu by selecting the gene-specific tab. I enter my gene of interest and select a molecular profile. I'm going to select this mRNA profile, but the same approach will work for any of the profiles listed. This chart adds now at the bottom of the page. And now there are a few ways we can use this chart to define our groups for comparison. One option is to directly highlight a range of expression values and then use the groups menu available at the top of the page to save that set of samples as a group. I can then do that again, define a second group with different expression values, and then I'll be able to compare them. Alternatively, we go back to the chart, you'll see that we have options to directly compare samples based on quartiles of expression, above or below the median value, or the current bins in the histogram. I'm going to select quartiles. This brings us directly to the group comparison feature, with four groups of samples representing the four quartiles of expression. Now I can compare among them, for example, looking at differences in outcomes. I can also deselect the middle two groups to compare just the highest versus lowest quartiles. Depending on your question of interest, you can explore the other tabs here in group comparison. We hope you found this video helpful. If you have additional questions, please check out the other resources listed here or reach out to us by email.